This is Teacher Morris, and today's video we will discuss about solving quartile of ungrouped data. So first is, what is median? In the diagram, line AB represents a rank data. So here A, D, C, E, and B. So line AB represents a rank data. So number one, what does C represents, or the middle? Number two, if D is the midpoint of AC, find its coordinates in terms of X and Y. Number three, if E is the midpoint of BC, or line BC, find its coordinates in terms of X and Y. So the median divides the distribution into two equal parts. It is in the point in the distribution where one half of the distribution lies below it or above it. From the illustration line AB, one half of the distribution lies below point C and one half of it lies above point C. Thus, C is the median. So what is a quartile? Quartiles are values that divide a set of data into four equal groups. There are three quartiles denoted Q1, Q2, and Q3, which are the first, lower, second, and third or upper quartiles respectively. Graphical representation of quartile. So the graphical representation below shows that 25% or 1/4 of the data will be less than or equal to first quartile, so 25%, and at least 75% will be greater than or equal to quartile 1. So the second quartile or quartile 2 is the median of the data. At least 75% of the data will be less than or equal to quartile 3, while at least 25% will be equal or greater than quartile 3. Thus, that is Q1 is less than Q2 and less than Q3. The difference between Q1 and Q3 is the interquartile range. So, formula. To find the value of quartile, we use the formula. So, this is the quartile formula for ungrouped data. So, the formula is Q(k) equals k times n plus 1 over 4, where k is the nth quartile and n is the number of data. Example of finding first quartile of ungrouped data. The following are the number of minutes spent by 15 grade 10 students on their online class in mathematics. Find Q1, Q2, and Q3 and interpret the results. So we have here the data: 15, 25, 30, 18, 40, 45, 10, 18, 20, 50, 30, 23, 25, 37, 24. So we have to arrange the data in ascending or increasing order, or from lowest data to highest data. So we have here 10, 15, 18, 18, 20, 23, 24, 25, 25, 30, 30, 37, 40, 45, and 50. So it is in ascending or increasing order. So we have here the formula. Q sub 1 is equals to K times N plus 1 over 4. So over 4, since a quartile is divided into 4 equal parts. So we have to substitute the formula. Since we have to find the first quartile, so our K is 1 times 15, our N, or the total number of data, which is 15 plus 1 over 4. So equals 16 divided 4 is equals to 4. So this means that the value of the first quartile is the fourth data, which is 18. This means that 25% of the data is less than or equal to 18. So from here is the first quartile. So less than or equal to 18. Example of finding a second quartile of ungrouped data. So here we have the second quartile. So our K is 2. So we have to substitute. The total number of data is 15 plus 1 over 4. So 2 times 15 plus 1 is 16 times 2 over 4. So 16 times 2 is 32 over 4, so is equals to 8. So the value of the second quartile is 8 data, that is equal to 25. So let us count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So this 25 is the second quartile. It means 50% of the data are less than or equal to 25. So we have here the third quartile of ungrouped data. So arrange the data in ascending or increasing order. So we have here the value for K, which is 3, because we have to find the quartile 3. K times N plus 1 over 4 is the formula. So 15 plus 1 is 16. 16 times 3 over 4 is equals to 12. So our quartile 3, the value for the third quartile is the 12th data, that is equal to 37. So we will count from the first 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So since this is the 12th data, so this is the 75% of the data, which is equal to less than or equal to 37. What is interquartile range? The difference between Q sub 1 and Q sub 3 is the interquartile range. Example, Q sub 3 is minus Q sub 1. So the value for Q sub 3 is 37 minus 18 for the value of Q sub 1. So 37 minus 18 is equals to 19. So that is the interquartile range. So that's all for today, guys. So don't forget to subscribe, like, and watch my videos and share. This is Teacher Morris and believes that everything is simple unless you make it complicated. Thank you, everyone. See you in my next video.